tell us, what does original mean to you?
Original. Something different, something unique. I mean, I think that's pretty technical, isn't it? That's what it is. But maybe if you're an original person, you're living to your heart, you know, completely original.
So you're across so many different things, and we'll get into that a little bit later, but where do you draw your inspiration from?
Mostly music and images. I'll say images because I will spend forever searching the internet and books and look at images from everything from art to fashion images. So I'd say images and the colours and all the textures and things that you can find there and music, put them together.
You call yourself a gypsy rock and roller. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, that's kind of how I describe my music. It's old school rock and roll, you know, Rolling Stones, the Kinks kind of stuff. And gypsy, I say, because it's still got that little... I mean, I started with the singer-songwriter thing and acoustic stuff, so it's still got that bohemian kind of thing to it. So it's a little bit in both sides.
You've managed to combine fashion, art and music, and you've done it really successfully. So do you want to walk us through it? How did it all happen?
I did music. I grew up doing dancing and did music for my whole life, and then once I'd finished high school, or towards the end, I needed to find a way to keep performing. So I was already playing guitar and just started doing gigs. And that kind of went to tours and like recording my own stuff, writing my own stuff. And that escalated to I came over here and I'd done some tours and then...
You just moved on each time a little bit more.
Yeah, and I always go back and forth. I find that if I'm doing the music stuff, I start thinking about designing fashion or making things or how what will look good with this music, you know, and vice versa. If I'm working on the fashion stuff, I need my guitar, you know, so I'm just
wired all the time.
I just like, I've got to do one or the other, so yeah.
Speaking of the fashion side of things, I know your face at the moment is on a shirt in Zara.
Yeah.
What's it like seeing your face on someone else's body?
It's really bizarre. Actually, my best friend bought the T-shirt and she Instagrammed. She's like, this is a little bit weird. Yeah. I've got one, but I've never worn it because I'm like, it just hangs in my wardrobe. I'm like, that's really cool.
If you could choose just one, so one between being a musician, an artist, a blogger, a fashion stylist, fashion icon, which one would it be and why?
I'd choose music because I get the most out of it and I can always pull things together and wear it on stage, you know, for the fashion side of things. But I think music, that's where my heart is, because you can just keep creating and tell your stories, work through your problems, work through your heartache, work through all the good stuff, and yeah, so I choose music.
You sound super busy. What do you do to relax?
Actually playing gigs, like playing music is really relaxing for me because I feel like I'm at home and it just feels really natural. So I'm lucky that I got to turn that into a job, you know.
What's up next for you? Where can we find your stuff? What are you doing?
I am working on some more fashion stuff. So I'm hoping to have some things ready for summer and into next year. A few collaborations are in the works. And music-wise, I'm recording a new EP. So some new releases with music. And I'm starting on a bit of a online music video project, which encompasses all the fashion stuff as well.
Well, that's it. Thank you so much for joining us here. Everyone else, if you want to check her out, check out mojomade.blogspot.com.au.